dedication to the independent woman, to the one working hard for hers. This is just my way of letting you know I see you, baby. And I brought a friend along to help me show my appreciation the right way. Ladies, Mr. Jamie Foxx. Mr. Foxx, ladies.
Remix. I love her cause she got her own. She don't need mine just to leave mine alone. There ain't nothing that's more sexy than the girl that won't but don't need me. Young, independent, yeah, she work hard. But you can't tell from the way that she walks. She don't slow down cause she ain't got time to be complaining, shorty gon' shine. She don't expect nothing from no guy. She plays aggressive, but she still shy. But you never know her softer side by looking in her eyes. Knowing she can do for herself makes me wanna give her my wealth. Only kind of girl I want, independent queen working for her. She got her own. She got her own. I love her cause she got her own. She got her own. I love it when she say,
it's cool, I got it, I got it, I got it.
I love it when she say,
it's cool, I got it, oh, I got it, I got it.
Remix.
I love her cause she got her own. She still leave mine alone. There ain't nothing that's more sexy than the girl that want but don't need me. Love me face, nice thick thighs, cause she got drive that matches my drive. Sexy thing, she stay fly all while paying her bills on time. She don't look at me like Captain Save 'em. Gold digging, no she don't do that. Now she look at me like inspiration. She wanna be complimenting my swag. And everything she got, she work for it. Good life made for it. She take pride in saying that she paid for it. Only kind of girl I want. Independent queen working for her throne. I love her cause she got her own. She got her own. Oh, I love her cause she got her own.
Put your hands in your pocket.
She got it.
Gotta love that though. Low so. She ain't no so, baby.
Hey. Don't make me laugh, boo. Never did that bad to make you even have to. But even if I had to, ask my better half to, you be more than glad to. When I do that math, boo, you always try to add to. I need someone who ride for me.
So I can talk about these hating ass motherfuckers. So you got a desperate bum who is willing to do anything for validation. First of all, bum, let me start off by saying this, okay? You are not smart enough, wealthy enough, none of y'all, okay? None of y'all are smart enough, intelligent enough, and you don't have enough money to rewrite history. Now, everybody that knows all of us knows that Tiffany Chrisman has been stalking me for years. It began hard body in 2015 when I moved to Georgia. At that time that I moved to Georgia, me and Tiffany were not talking at all. So she had no idea what was going on in my life. I had quit fucking with her by that time. And the reason why I quit fucking with Tiffany, coincidentally, is because she had punched her son in the face at my house. And I didn't appreciate her treating her kid like that. And then also, bum, you see, you're forgetting that I know Tiffany. Okay, so if Tiffany is using you as some kind of fucking witness or something, nobody is a better witness than me. you said you ain't never seen Tiffany's dust. She was living in a shanty in Grandview, Missouri, with dead horse flies in the fucking window that she refused to clean for a year. Tiffany is an alcoholic and she has a lot of health problems. Okay. Now I'm sick of you, bum. I really am. First of all, the only reason why you bigging up Tiffany is because I guess she looks slightly better than Kat. Okay. The only reason why you're even bearing false witness against her and her many, many flaws is because you don't want to make yourself look bad. That's the problem. Okay, so you come online, Tiffany comes online with more Spanx than the fucking law should allow. Right? Spanx and push-up bras. Why you not telling them the truth about Tiffany having long-ass titties that look like tube socks? You're forgetting, bum. I have seen Tiffany naked. Okay, so that's number one lie. Number two, why didn't you take any video footage of Tiffany's face in that footage? I'm going to tell you why. Because Tiffany's face has been destroyed by the toxic relationships and her drug use and alcohol abuse. Tiffany looks like a 50-year-old biker chick. She looks terrible. I'm talking about liver spots, brown spots. Okay, when I seen her in 2014, and I hope she still don't have this, the bleeding tooth. But see, a bum like you would be desperate. You just want to say that you're sleeping with a white woman or you're talking to a white woman because you're desperate. Okay? When if you have met her in person, you know exactly what the fuck Tiffany looks like. And she looks much older than me. Much older. Okay? And that's crazy because she's younger than me. Her skin is damn near gray. There's no way that Tiffany would be able to leave the house without makeup, without people knowing that she has some sort of drug or alcohol problem. Okay, so this is the reason why nobody sees Tiffany from the front. We never saw her face. And the only thing that we do see is pictures of her either in the dark or with filters. Okay, so this is what you're not telling people now. You know that Tiffany is a prostitute. You know that she is. That was a lover's argument that me, I don't even have to explain that shit. This is some shit you done cooked up with old girl whose name I'm not even gonna call. I'm not even gonna call her name, hun. You're a liar. You're a fucking fraud. I was upset in that video because Mike had said something really upsetting to me. Because he would not send me any money because he said that I had been bad. And I said, Mike, I need you to send me some money. Okay. And so that's how that argument came about. That's the only reason why I even said that. Okay. And see, this is where, if you want to really go deep into this, I guess, Real Roach Radio investigation on me, I can prove my income. If I were accused of prostitution by any federal agency, government agency, or police agency, I would be able to prove my income and how I make it. Can you? No, you can't, bum, because there is no income. First of all, after I made that video, I think I was sent like maybe about $200 in donations from the people that fuck with me. Okay. And then also I get clients all the time for spell work. Okay. You know, you are really pathetic that you would attack a woman that's dealing with issues like that with a man. You're disgusting. And then also, bum, let's point this out. you're making fun of me because I was a concerned parent in that video. With a man like you, there is no concern. You just have went around to several Black women making children that have to be supported by the state. A man like you don't have to worry about what the fuck you're going to feed your children or how you're going to get food money. If you're living a real fucking life that doesn't involve being given food stamps and having everything fucking given to you, then you would fucking know the real pressure of being a parent. So it's funny how you would mention that. And yeah, that's why you're always talking about call the state, because a man like you needs the state to support your own children. And see, right now, I can fucking expose myself and show receipts of my grocery bill where I pay for my groceries with my fucking debit card. Every time you lying, delusional people would call people to my house, it was always a refrigerator full of food, freezer full of food. So, you know, it's just, it's real strange. You know what I'm saying? And you've just got your own little weird dialect over there, this fucking delusion that you're in as you sit there and go, hey, let me go drop some nug over here or there, because you don't actually take life seriously. You don't take being a man or a father seriously. You wouldn't give a fuck if your kids ate or not. You don't have that kind of pressure. You just say, hey, food stamps, wit. That's how your children ate. That's the only reason why you have babies walking around here is because of WIC and the goddamn state. Otherwise, a man like you, you have no responsibility, not really. And see, that's the women in your life's fault. Okay, and Tiffany ain't no different. You are exactly her type. She loves losers. Hey, I wish y'all the best. The problem is, bum, is that as soon as you hooked up with Tip Tap, you decided to use it as an opportunity to stalk me. And the only reason why you think in your fucking delusional, low quality, low self-esteem having ass mind that you're going to actually get away with doing the fuck shit that you've done and then rewriting history. Nigga, you stalked me all throughout motherfucking 2020, 2019, 2018, 2017, nigga. And you just dropped revenge porn on me. Wow, you're really hurt about something. The reason why you don't actually talk about Tiffany's flaws, because we're going to get deep into Tiffany's flaws. Tiffany is this beautiful woman that just has it all. Why does she have long titties and a saggy ass filled with cellulite? Why she got all this shit going on in the back of her legs? Why she got varicose veins and shit? Why are her fucking ankles so swollen that it's a wonder that the bitch can even breathe properly? So not only that, this bitch running around here with a health problem. She ain't even healthy physically. The reason why you're bigging her up is because she needs you to sell her. A man that's in love with a woman, he's not going to come and say, hey, everybody, my woman's pussies taste like fucking strawberry cupcakes. Because a man that wants a woman to himself is not going to be advertising her. My goodness, you act like you trying to sell your hoe. What's up, minimalistic life? Her pussy smell like sunshine or something, you said. Not the Tiffany that I know. Tiffany has a reputation of smelling bad down in her vagina area. And I think it's hilarious that she tries to make it look like, and see, she's doing the best that she can to look like a good hoe. But in reality, that's all she is a hoe. Tiffany, when in the fuck have I ever been afraid of you stealing my man? I told you, I said, come on down here and meet up with Mike. I can guarantee you that he's going to come right back to me. But even though I wouldn't want you to do that, because God only knows what you have going on in your body. I mean, shit, you never know. It could be syphilis, because the bitch lost her fucking mind. You know, the bum is just a nothing ass naker is what he is. looking for Scooby snacks. And so are you, Tiffany. You need for the bum to come online and say, oh yeah, da 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 da, because you're selling ass on here. And really who you trying to sell your ass to is Mike. That's why the bum purposely comes on there and bigs you up and says this stupid shit about me, because he actually would like for you, he would like for Mike to want you, but I know that Mike doesn't want you, Tiffany, at all. In fact, he hates you so much that he broke up with me last year just because he thought I wanted you because of you and that dumbass bum. When you know goddamn well I ain't contacted you since 2014. And then you brought up De Niro Red. Wow. Wow. You were chasing and stalking his mother around, trying to prove that you made more money than me, which at the time I wasn't making no money. I hadn't even barely started my business. And you was like, I can pay you more. You were literally running around trying to convince these men that you can pay them more. And bitch, that's why I told you I don't sit with you, because I don't get treated like that. And I'm not no prostitute, but I'm not going to sit up here and pay. Like, it seemed like to me, Tiffany, that you're trying to purposely get pimped. That's what it looks like to me. And that's what that whole get up is about. And it's fucked up when your pussy is so stank that you got to talk about another bitch just to get somebody to even look at you. Now, when the lights is off, I'm sorry, on, and when it's not dark, you're going to be able to see all of the holes in your ass. I remember Tiffany had gained some weight and she was like, oh, I'm so sexy, because she had gained some weight. And literally, it just looked like a bunch of goddamn fucking blubber. And Tiffany's weight does go up and down. It does. Her weight goes up and down. But Tiffany will one day be 200 pounds, and then a month later, she'll be 150 pounds. It's very weird how she can just shapeshift. And then she also has this health problem that causes the entire front part of her face to swell up like a goddamn reptilian or something. Like, I ain't never seen no white people do that shit. And the bitch is obsessed with me. You are actually bragging about a woman that is obsessed with me, clearly. Okay, now, bum, I know that you don't have a lot of intelligence. Do you not understand that the reason why I went live and spoke about what I can see the lies that she's typing in your chat, because that's libel that she's doing, that's slander and libel. When I went live and addressed it, that is the reason why, not because I'm stalking Tiffany. What the fuck are you talking about? I moved 1,000 miles away from her. Are you for real? And you really want people to believe this? People don't believe it. They just like the fuckery. Stop trying to sell this shit as real life. You don't know a fucking thing about my real life. Neither does she, because I haven't spoken with Tiffany in several years. Now, I'm not trying to impede on Tiffany obviously selling her ass, but I can promise you that the pussy does not smell or look like sunshine. I don't understand why you're selling her pussy, but you're using the image of mine. People are going to probably contact her expecting to see what you showed, which was my pussy and Mike's dick. They're going to expect that, but they're going to get Tiffany, a dried up fucking bloated ass fucking hag. I'm a little confused, bum. Whose ass are you selling? Me and Mike's or Tiffany's? And I'm pretty sure that that monkey was funky after her twat stank after you went down on her, because we all know that that mouth is yuck. But what difference did it make? It would just add to the stank that's already there. Now, Tiffany, Franklin is dead and in the ground. And, you know, there was some things that popped off. She said that I was afraid. First of all, girl, you didn't hook up with Aaron until Ty was like 8 years old. So would you still, we had been broke up. I had another baby and you were still stalking me. And I believe the only reason why you had that child was so that you could form some kind of cord with me for life. That's why you did it. Okay. Now, the relationship between you and Aaron was a disaster. You slept with his little nephew. What are you talking about? And then Frankie called you one morning and told you that your pussy stunk. When in the hell, and literally right after we had our incident, Frankie actually proposed marriage to me. What man have I been afraid of you stealing? This is the fucking story that you have been telling. Who have you stole from me? Who? Because as far as I'm concerned with your behavior and the type of woman that you are, a man that you would take from me, that would be a blessing. Because you would be a curse on his fucking life, literally. Here's another thing I want to tell y'all. Fuck that. I'm exposing you today. You can flag it if you want. Tiffany started going through this thing where she just started sleeping with I don't know what the fuck it was about. It was like she had so many fucking sexual partners, abortions. It just, oh my fucking God, this. When I noticed that even at the age of 30 something, that Tiffany was still the same way and had not fucking matured, that's when I walked away. See, I know that a lot of these people on the Bums platform, they're either drunk, low lifes, brain dead, and you really don't give a fuck about the truth. But see, Bum, I am never gonna allow you to get away with this, because that bitch told a lot of lies on me. A lot. Now, I don't know what the fuck makes you think just because y'all bumped pelvises that it's gonna make a goddamn difference. Neither one of y'all have any power. You live in your fucking mama's basement, and this bitch is still living, she's still working as a damn property manager, living on property. She lose her goddamn job. She ain't got nowhere to live. That's why, and girl, the only person that is afraid right now, Tip Tap, is you being afraid of somebody calling up to your job. See, Tiffany, I control the flow of my business. You work for somebody. You're not a boss. So right now, what you're afraid of is somebody calling up to your job. And bitch, you're not going to blame this shit on me. Blame it on that worthless ass fucking bum. That bum has done nothing but brought bad energy to your job. Oh, is that my fault too, bitch? Really? Really? Maybe it is. Because maybe you deserve a little bit of fucking karma. I still have people making videos about me accusing me of being a pedophile. I could literally throw this nothing ass raggedy bitch in prison. Even just accusing somebody of rape or statutory rape publicly could have ruined my life. So, nigga, I don't know what the fuck you talking about. I have very powerful and strong spirits that exposed it all. Okay. And see what you do, Bum, because you're so distraught, a crackhead, and just a low-lifeted motherfucker. The reason why you do this shit is because you're desperate. What the fucker? Why would I need to be desperate? Desperate of what? Mike looks better than you. What the fuck? You were over there literally salivating over his dick, Bum. I wasn't even gonna do this show, y'all. I swear to God, I wasn't even gonna do this show. Bum, it is so obvious that you are obsessed with Mike's and other men's penises. And Tiffany is obviously obsessed with other women's coochies. I've heard a lot of women coochies being exposed in that black sector. Have I ever called somebody and said, hey, send me that? I've only had people tell me about it. Remember when you showed me Tina's cooch? No, there isn't. And then you lied that quick. Why do you lie so much? Trust me, if there were any other pictures, you would have exposed it. Oh, yeah. Your thirsty ass would have exposed it because you're a retard. I mean, I honestly believe that a man like you wouldn't even be able to handle having sex with or a relationship with a real woman. And then you sit your ass over there and you listen to a videotape of a mother working hard to feed her children with her own money, not the state's money. And you actually call it the dust? Are you fucking kidding me? No, let me tell you what the fucking dust is. The dust is a man that goes around making children by several women that he doesn't actually support. The only motherfucker that's dusty is you. See, that was normal shit. That would be just like if I had a job and somebody were threatening my job, I would be concerned about how am I going to feed my children. Not you, bomb. You wouldn't give a fuck. When them food stamps run out, you'd be like, fuck them kids. You don't spend none of your money. You spend all your money on crack, cigarettes, and coffee. Well, I'm sorry. You can buy coffee with food stamps. Crack, cigarettes, and you're probably trying to petition the court so that you can buy cigarettes with food stamps, and it's not going to happen. But I can guarantee you that you go to the store when you get your food stamp benefit, and some of them stores around there where you live, they'll sell you some you know, cigarettes or blunts for food stamps. And that's your life. That's what fed your kids. It's, you know, and you just really don't know anything about the real world. If the government were to cut your food stamps off, if they were to cut stamps, your children would be starving. And it's because of women like me why that benefit is even there. You don't give a fuck. You don't. You don't have a food budget. You're not balancing your fucking checkbook. You don't have to look ahead 3-4 days at a time, make sure you buy enough food for your family. You do not do that. Your life, you don't even live a real life. You're in the matrix, dummy. And you're going to talk to somebody about the dust when you done raised 7 children on the system, raised them, created more children to go, trying to create more children to go on the system. And see, men like you need a fucking wake-up call. You know that? So, yeah, you keep playing this video as if that's supposed to be a shame on me. Really? And then you tried to spin it. Oh, you real butthurt now. Now I'm starving my kids. Wow. Wow. I mean, you are really hurt. I thought you had Tiffany. I'm a little confused. Because you know that you don't. Tiffany ain't been back. Now, I don't give a fuck if she does come back. It wouldn't be news to me at all. But the whole point of it is that, well, part of the reason why she ain't came back is because of the dust. The dust. Okay, you don't even have a driver's license. You talk all this shit about other people while you sit there and get taken care of by your mama in the goddamn state of Michigan. These are the facts. You know, there are men sitting at home right now checking their checkbook, and they planning dinner. They like, how can I make the best, healthiest meal with the budget that I have right now? Not you, bomb. And if the food stamps run out, you'll say, well, bitch, what you spent all the food stamps on? Well, first of all, bum, food stamps are supposed to only supplement the food in the house. It's not supposed to replace the whole goddamn food bill. That's why your ass was up at goddamn Chuck E. Cheese arguing with them about why you couldn't buy goddamn pizza at Chuck E. Cheese with food stamps. They don't take food stamps at Chuck E. Cheese, bum. They don't. And the dust, you don't, like, literally, let me tell you something, hon. Tiffany, your girl that got grit, she got money, she a boss player, for real, she a boss. This bitch damn near killed herself and her kids when Aaron moved to fucking Iowa. Aaron moved to Iowa and he went down there to get his tooth fixed and cut her goddamn food stamps off. That bitch damn near lost her fucking mind. This motherfucker don't pay no child support. The least he could do is she kept our food stamp going because Tiffany was frauding the state, you see. Tiffany, the job that she was working at that time was paying about $40,000, $50,000. Okay, I don't know why she was living in that crappy ass fucking crack looking house. I don't know what the fuck was up with that. That's a sign. When you make that good of money and your house look like shit, that means that you must be budgeting, you a functioning crackhead or something. Okay. This heifer damn near lost her mind. I sat down and talked to her. I said, Tiffany, I said, it's going to be okay. You make enough money budgeted. She sat there and was fuming mad at Aaron for cutting off them food stamps. Also, she lies a lot. You do not have a good relationship with Aaron or his family. Not really. His sister Nikki uses the fuck out of you. But other than that, you embarrassed Aaron because you slept with his little nephew. And probably more than one, perhaps. So you want to talk about relationships? Like, Tiffany, you have came to YouTube and totally created this false narrative about yourself. Not to mention the child abuse. Hell, there's been times when I've had to make this dish called goulash. I was waiting on my direct deposit. And I might have had some potatoes or some corned beef hash or something. Some eggs or something. That's real life, bum. Not at the first of the month, everybody got food stamps and then everybody running around. See, that's what you do, bum. You get your food stamps at the beginning of the goddamn month. And by the end of the fucking month, you online trying to squeeze blood literally out of my ass for donations. This, your life sucks. Not only that, the female that you're doing all this does not look the way that she could. She's a catfish. Tiffany is a catfish. It looks like somebody literally busted her in her goddamn face with a fucking shovel. Literally. Not to mention all of the scars and bruises on her for being a hoe. There's a reason why I don't have scars and bruises on my body. I'm not going to say I've never been abused physically by a man, but shit. She a hoe. And you know she's a hoe. And I don't even know why you, like, really? Really? And this is where you get your clout from, lying on somebody. Cause obviously she a hoe and she fucked up about it. And it doesn't surprise me. I don't know why old girl is still beefing with me. I ain't even gonna call your name, girl. No. But it is awfully strange how you have all of the stalkers in your chat room stalking me at the same time. You're not going to tell the fact that Tiffany's cooch smells like the goddamn sewer. You're not going to talk about the fact that her, because Bomb, let's face it, you're used to eating women with funky coochies. Okay, somebody having a smell in their house because houses have odors sometimes, you know, that's it's a part of life, Bomb. But that don't mean that when you pull my underwear down that my cooch is going to smell like garbage. So you're not going to be honest about the fact that she smells like literal fucking hot garbage down there. And you're not going to tell about the cellulite and the many, many holes that's in her skin. Everybody looks good bent over. So you've been running around here trying to compare her to me, which is so hilarious because both of us have had children. She's a lot taller than me. I'm only 5'4". Tiffany's like 5'8 or 5'9-ish. You're not going to talk about the them swole ass goddamn legs. And then you be running around here talking about you got a thyroid and you got diabetes. Shit, what do you think she got? They're going to have to amputate them fucking legs. And I know for a fact that she still has leg pain. I know everything about her. And see, this is fucked up that she's this stupid to continue this shit on, knowing people are not going to believe you over me, Tiffany. Why would I lie on you for what, Tip Tap? The only thing that validates you is that I responded to you. And the reason why I'm responding to you, the only reason is because I knew your ass for 20 years. Also, another thing, you're lying again. You see, you're claiming that you knew Aaron longer than me, and that's not the truth. That's a stupid, petty, retarded thing to lie about. Okay, you did not know Aaron longer than me. In fact, I was always welcome in his family home, and you weren't. His grandmother spit at you and told you to get the fuck out from in front of her door. Is that not what was happening, Tip Tap? So it wasn't me that whose family was friends with Aaron, because you know that Aaron's uncle was literally like the love of my life, of my aunt. They're both passed on now. So I know Aaron and met Aaron through my family. You weren't around for any of that, Tip Tap. I didn't meet you until Aaron went out there to pick you up so that his cousins could gangbang you. And why are you so embarrassed and ashamed about it? Like, you've admitted to this. Now, for some reason, you're ashamed about it. You already told people, like, everybody that I know knows you. Remember the conversation that you had with Vale? He said, what do you like to do, Tiffany? And she said, I like to get drunk and fuck a bunch of niggas at the same time. And he was like, what she like to do? Oh, she like to fall in love and get stuck on one dude. Remember that conversation that y'all had? Okay, and Vail wasn't my man. Me and him just had a brief affair. That was it. You are constantly coming online trying to compete with me. And it's so stupid because there is no competition and there is no comparison between me and you. Stop comparing yourself to me. And that bum needs to quit comparing himself. You need to quit comparing it either, because you know what it looks like, Bomb? It looks like who you are more into is Mike and me. That's who it looks like you're more into. Mike and me. Okay, and you wish I was a prostitute. If I were a prostitute, I would probably be more open to sleeping with you, which I imagine that even if I were, I don't think, Bomb, I can see, I'm not a prostitute, but I do talk to a lot of sex workers. I've had sex workers as clients before. I don't discriminate against nobody. And they would classify you as somebody that they would not accept as a John. See, you're more so in the lower hemisphere of crackheadedness. You are a crackhead, bum. You even make the crack movements and sounds with your mouth, because I think that people that smoke crack, like a coating comes over their tongue, and you just be like, I don't know if you be sucking on lollipops, pretending it, or if you've been smacking, you be smacking your lips, and then you always looking at Mike's dick pics. You are a disgusting motherfucker. And you're lonely, very lonely. If you had women, you wouldn't be online all day, every goddamn day stalking me and Mike. Because trust me, I don't think that either one of us act like you think that people like to do this for fun. And I know that I don't want either one of you stalking me. It's absolutely pathetic. It's absolutely pathetic for a woman to be so goddamn self-conscious that she has had to present herself like the way Tiffany has presented herself to a bunch of people, and you think people don't fucking know what you about. You think people are stupid. People know what you about. They just there for the fuckery. And then another thing, stop with the goddamn fucking lie roasting and shit. Bringing up lie roasts to piss people off. Y'all must be some lonely ass people, because what y'all like to do is, if y'all think me and Mike are back together, you instantly start to try to break us up. Y'all have been doing this consistently for 2 years. Bum, the reason why you have been discussing your sex life that happened a year ago, because you want to make yourself look more interesting, more acceptable when you're not. You're never going to be accepted as long as you are not supporting. And you got little kids. See, you always show your older children. What y'all don't see is them three little ones that Michelle got. And, Bum, when you're live, like when I come on here and I'm doing readings and I get donations, or either people buy spells and readings from me, that's going to my family. That's going directly to my children. The money you make is going directly to your crack dealer. Is that not the truth? See, I told you in 2017, I could recognize you. I can tell by looking at you, them swole eyes and the way your eyes bug out of your damn face. I can tell that you're smoking crack. You are factually a crackhead. And I believe Tiffany is too. Okay, because I believe that birds of a feather flock together. So y'all just had a drug-filled, alcohol-filled weekend together, and y'all been carrying it out for the past goddamn year to try to make this an L for somebody when it's only an L for the two of you. In fact, how fucked up can your life be if you a grown-ass woman stalking somebody that moved 1,000 miles away from you? How can you even claim that when we got you on candid camera? We got you caught on camera stalking me. Tiffany had no idea that I was recording that conversation. She had no idea. She was too drunk and high and out of her fucking mind to give a fuck. So it's the evidence is there. What did you think, Bomb? You thought that Real Roach Radio was going to fucking make this goddamn funky ass pig? This fucking stuffed ass fucking pig? And then you've been sneak dissing her too, because you said something about varicose veins. Tiffany actually has varicose veins in her fucking face. And you said that shit last year. Let me ask you a question, Bum. How about you go live and make a video with Tiffany and show her face? What she can't afford the laser surgery? She's waiting to get laser surgery, because I've already challenged you to do that. You wouldn't even show this woman's face. You know why you didn't show her face? Because her face is fucked up. I don't know what the fuck, man. I think her karma bad. And she gonna have to go get some kind of laser surgery for that shit. She got like, it's so bizarre. Like when I saw her, I was like, how in the fuck did you get veins running down your goddamn eye, like from her eyes all the way down? And then you talking shit about the way some bum, everybody that you say is unattractive is actually beautiful. And everybody that you say is attractive is actually ugly. And I don't even see how you can even see people straight anyway, because your eyes is floating around in your goddamn head. Listen, bum, you are not intelligent enough to rewrite this history. There are over 50 police reports that I filed in DeKalb County, Georgia, with Tiffany's fucking name on it. There's way too much evidence to prove otherwise. I've never contacted Tiffany's family. I've never contacted anybody to reach out to her. I've never done anything. It's only been Tiffany doing that. In fact, Tiffany is stalking my family right now. And my family don't even like her. That's why I ain't even upset with my mother for being all on her face, because I know my mom don't really like her. She never did like her. Okay, and Tiffany actually acknowledged that in a text message with Tina. Tina sent me all the evidence and footage. And I meant to not bring up her name, but Tina, I was bringing up your name for purposes of the discussion. Now, if you want to get mad at me and then you're talking about somebody's friends, Tiffany, you know, you are. I can't believe that she actually said in the bum's chat room and tried to play the Jedi mind trick like she's goddamn Princess Layla when she's nobody's princess, okay, at all. Talking about, oh, you're not gonna have any friends left except for Jamila. Bitch, do you really think that Mike considers any of you people to really be his friends? You thought you and Mike were friends. That's really what you thought. And you know what? Who the fuck do you think you're dealing with, Tiffany? You think that everybody is lonely like the bum? Mike has real life friends in his real life. He has a life. The only reason why he even fucks with you in the first place is so that he could get close to me, girl. Uh-huh. That's why he did that. So you continuously do this shit. Why do y'all continuously fucking embarrass yourselves? You've got to be at least a little bit embarrassed for continuing to stalk a woman that wants not a goddamn thing to do with you. Everybody in my life knows that. Do I call you? Do I write letters? I even knew where the fuck you worked. Goddamn, Tiffany, if I wanted to talk to you so bad, I could have called you at your job. I know exactly where you work. You even made it known where you work at. You were obviously opening up some kind of invitation for me to call you, and I never did. And you know what it is? It's your false ass fucking ego. For some reason, you think in your fucking mind, first of all, I ain't fucking with you. You are a racist. I didn't find out until I unfriended you how fucking racist you are. You treat black people like animals, like they ain't shit. But when it came to Kat Smith, she let up on that shit real quick. Y'all noticed that. Oh, we're still friends. And I would never, because she's a white person staying on cold with another white person. See, as a black person, I'm pretty universal. I fuck with whoever fuck with me. Okay, so I don't do the whole racial thing, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, when it comes to white women, like, I'm sorry, it's too much of a coincidence that I've now had two obsessive sociopathic stalker white women. And Janice is working her way up to try to fit your shoes, Tiffany. So now we got Janice stalking me. And it's because you refuse to just bow your ass down. Bitch, I'll never fuck with you. What the fuck? You think I'm gonna call you and apologize to you, bitch? Oh my God, girl, you'll never get that phone call, Tiffany. Not ever. Okay. You use troll pressure, crackheads, and lies to try to control the narrative of the situation, but everybody knows that you're a liar, and the both of you need to quit trying to fucking act like you know me in real life, especially that bum. And he's so sick. This bum is so sick that he wanted to form a cord to me. Then you tried to accuse me of doing the same thing. I met up with Mikey because I wanted to. I met up with Mikey and kept seeing him because I liked him. The shit you and that bitch got going on ain't got nothing to do with nothing fucking real. It's all about coming to YouTube talking shit because you don't have enough going on in your real fucking life. That's why the only thing you can bring up is shit that you've heard us say online. Otherwise, you don't know shit, you ain't seen shit, and you'll never come anywhere fucking near my fucking house, bum. And we all know you thirsty. Because remember last year when I exposed you again? I wonder if Tiffany was actually mad about that. Not really, because Tiffany likes to do weird shit like threesomes and shit. Remember when you decided that you was going to treat me better than Michael and all that shit, but you don't really know how Michael treats me in real life, okay? And you said, I'm coming down there to take you out for dinner. Why would I want to sit there with somebody with fucking halitosis, herpes all over his fucking mouth, and have dinner with you? What the fuck makes you think that I want to have dinner with you? Because you are hoping that you're going to get some kind of date out of this, either with me or Mike or both. And I'm not interested at all. I've told you that so many times. When you and Cliff had asked me to have a threesome with the two of you, I told you no. You are a disgusting bum. And you know what? Me and you are nothing alike. We are not the same at all. First of all, I would never be a woman that would get gangbanged. And that is a complete turnoff. The only kind of woman that would want you is somebody like Tiffany that likes to get gangbanged. I think I've probably had, I don't want to say the number, but it's definitely under 7 sex partners ever in my life. So if you're running around acting like a complete slut, fucking everybody, that means that you sexy. You people are really demented. No, I've been a kept woman. I don't, you know, even the past 8 years, I haven't slept with anybody except for Mike. You would like for me to change that shit. You would like to change that because you're so jealous. Stop worrying about what I do. It's none of your business. Why would, like, I'm sitting here listening to two men looking at dick pics and then gossiping and discussing a woman's sex life and what she does. Y'all are literally bum. You was raised by an ignorant ass single mother. That's why you go around talking about single mothers. Because in reality, you really mad at your fucking mama. Because she raised you to be the fuckwad that you are. You were actually showing dick pictures on the phone with somebody that sounds real sweet. What's up, cuz? Hey, y'all. Strange. Gossiping about another woman and her personal life, you have failed completely. Your YouTube career is shit. It doesn't matter how many live goddamn viewers you have. It does not matter. you were upset earlier because you only had about 30 live, 40, 50 watching live because they were sick of your ass. And then you said, let me put Jamila's name in the title because you desperate. Okay. You failed. You're not even monetized. What good would it do to, you can't even leave your videos up because you get flagged. What good, what, like you just, it just is completely worthless. And you sitting there thinking to yourself right now, I'm going to move in with one of these people. I'm going to move in with somebody. You looking for somebody to live off of again. And evidently, Tiffany must have got enough sense because Tiffany used to just move in, nothing ass niggas. She just move them in, don't even know her, barely know her fucking kids. She let a man that she only knew for a few days come in and man, that hey, bum. Let me tell you something. You need to quit talking all that shit because I actually know her and a lot of other people know her. And you really don't want me to get in touch with some people because it ain't even fucking worth all that. Everybody knows you're a fucking liar. You would only big her up because she looked better than Kat. And then that's all you got. You're going to ride it till the goddamn wheels fall off. And her wheels have already fell off. Anytime you're supposed to be a mother and this is all you do. All the time, all day, every day, this chick stalks me around fucking YouTube. She don't have enough sense or respect for her children, for my children, for the families involved with this. She don't have enough self-respect to stop the slander, the gossip, and the libel. So yeah, you've been notified anymore because everything I said was the truth and can be verified. Everybody knows that I'm telling the truth, everything. And I could tell more. I could tell more about Tiffany. It's a fucking shame how thirsty you are. You just, bum, have you not proved that you are the thirstiest man in social media? You have proven that over the past 2 years. And you know what, bum? I don't like you. I actually hate your motherfucking guts. And I'm still cursing you. We still on 2019, the shit that you did in 2019 when you stalked me and Mike on a daily fucking basis playing old roast videos telling us why we shouldn't like each other. You an ignorant piece of shit. And you're jealous and you are in a basement. You are living, your bedroom is in a basement. Because evidently somebody else is occupying the second bedroom or maybe the ceiling caved in. It must be something wrong with that second bedroom to where you have to go down in the basement. Okay, we all know that your house is dilapidated. Okay, and you know what's fucked up is that a father who don't worry about shit. Life is a free ride. Ooh, let me go nutting this bitch and nutting that bitch. And then after you realize that you're a fucking bum and a loser, you come online and talk about black women when you can't feed your children right now. Right now. You can't. If your children needed you to order them a goddamn pizza, bum, you would not be able to do it because you have already spent the money on crack. And that's the fucking reality of it. No, don't worry about my bills. Don't worry about my bills. You can tell that that's a troll from the bums chat room. Hun, how about the fact that your motherfucking ass ain't never paid no goddamn bill? You're not even a human being, bum. I'm sorry. You would not know how it feels to have bills coming to your house or a car payment. Bum, listen. You didn't get a car until your brother had to die for you to get a fucking car. You know how many goddamn cars I've had? You've had one car in your fucking life, bum, and that was the car that you got after your brother was killed. That's how much of a bum you are. 40 something years old, you had to wait until you was damn near 40 to get a car. Most of us have had plenty of many cars. You haven't had one on your own. Your priorities are fucked up. And you know what? I believe that the state of Michigan should be contacted. Since you want to say that I'm neglecting my kids, how about I send your portfolio to the state of Michigan and let the child support people know what you're doing instead of actively looking for a job? I wonder if the state of Michigan knows that you sit around and stalk and slander and harass people all day, every day, instead of handling your business. Huh? I wonder if you would get locked up for that. Come on, bum. We know a bum like you is behind on child support. We know you behind on child support. Okay, from Little Mar, the other one, you know, you got cases and cases and stacks of child support against you. And you know what? A lot of men who are intelligent, I've seen men your age, they'll have like 15,000 in arrears. They'll end up coming into some money and starting their own business. They'll just pay that shit. That will never happen for you because you're more concerned about bragging about a stank pussy and then trying to compare it to mine. So because her pussy stink, that mean I must stink? No, that's her. She stinks. Okay, and every other woman that you've dealt with has a smell down there, bum. We can tell by the way you talk about women. You're in competition with women. You were trying to use Tiffany as competition against me. I've already destroyed Tiffany. I destroyed Tiffany when she was on Mike's team. Y'all act like y'all like the pain or something. That don't make no sense to me. All of this has been exposed for years and years, bum. All of it. Okay, when you want to go back to the Blog Talk days, Tiffany and Kat was on Mike's show saying, "We're just worried about her. We don't know what she's doing. I don't know what she's doing right now leaving Kansas City. I can't drive to her in 45 minutes. We love her." And then when I came back with some bitch, you know I ain't fucking with you and you know why we fell out. That's when Tiffany started to act like a fucking thug and a gangster. When she saw I wasn't going for that dumb shit. I think Kat even tried to lie and say that I had amnesia. It was very, very weird. And a lot of you men that was thirsty enough to get either close to them or me, and I'm not saying Mike was thirsty at all. I just think that it was very interesting and it's all good. But bum, you could not wait to get next to Tiffany so that you could try with your unintelligent, unevolved ass. You got to have money to rewrite history. You don't have enough money for that and you never will. And I'm talking about money. Okay, and because white folk been trying to rewrite history for centuries and they can't do it. Okay, and see, you are absolutely a victim of white supremacy. Are you not? 40-something year old man living with your mama, sleeping in the basement, not taking care of your children, laughing at a mother that is concerned about food for her children because I don't have an EBT card. And there are sometimes people with EBT cards, they still need money to take care of their children. You wouldn't understand that. You would have no idea how much it actually takes to raise a child because you've never done it. But yet you call yourself a fucking father and you expect everybody to call you daddy. You don't even have a family home for your children. You're jealous of any man that has a family home for their children to come home to. All you have is that dilapidated ass shack or shanty over there in Michigan, and it ain't even yours. So you've been lying, trying to make it seem like Tiffany is, this sex goddess when in reality it's Spanx, a push-up bra, and a goddamn flattering outfit is all it is. Anybody can look good in, well, there's some people that wouldn't look good in that outfit. I won't mention them. But anybody will look good if they have somewhat of a shape in the outfit that she was wearing. You were too afraid to show her fucking face, and there was a reason for that. Okay, and she's the one that's got to cake her goddamn face up. So I've seen her without makeup on, fresh out of the fucking shower. She has varicose veins in her goddamn face like Hulk Hogan. Yes, she does. Okay, and you know what? You would take anybody that would be desperate enough to meet up with your stinking ass bum, you would big them up. You would make it look like, oh, they're so beautiful in real life, and she don't look good. Last time I saw Tiffany, I thought she was getting ready to die. I was worried about her. I was like, what the fuck? I was like, are you okay? So you can continue to sit up there and lie, bum, but I'm not a hoe. I don't need for you to advertise me. I'm a little confused as to why she's the hoe, but you're trying to lure Johns for her by showing my privacy? Wow, that's pretty desperate. That's sad when you a hoe and you can't even use your own vagina to lure men. And then I don't need for Mike to go on this platform and tell me how pretty I am or whatever. The fuck, I don't need that shit. I already know I'm pretty. But I understand why he doesn't do it. Mike ain't trying to do all that. Like, I ain't even gonna say what it is. You need to take your fucked up relationship with Tiffany and go down the fucking road, clearly, both of y'all, because remember last year when you said I was suicidal? What? You and Tiffany actually made a murder-suicide pact with each other because your lives suck. And that's fucked up for you to be in a goddamn 6 or 7 year goddamn depression. I hope that y'all go get some fucking help. I think that it does need to be brought to the attention, the stalking that you are doing. You are pathetic. You are not a father, bum. You will never turn on your camera and say, hey, y'all, you know, I done ran into a snag. You know, I need to get dinner for the family. You would never do that because you don't give a fuck. Your children was knocking at your damn closet door at Michelle's house. Your children was knocking at the door begging you to eat food, begging you to feed them. And you had a refrigerator full of because you had just got your food stamps. And you were so goddamn lazy. You supposed to be babysitting the kids while Michelle worked. You tell them to wait till they mama get home before they can eat something. And you know why you do that shit, bum? Because you know you're a neglectful father. You are. You're a very neglectful father. You'll never spend nights not sleeping. You know, a lot of people are very concerned about how their family is going to do. Being that you live in a shanty in Bum Harbor, you don't have to worry about any of that shit. You realize that we have experienced a global fucking pandemic, and only a person that actually really don't have no responsibility or life would be doing the dumb shit that you and Tiffany have been doing for the past couple of years. Okay, especially in 2020. You know, there's a lot of families facing homelessness and, you know, people with financial issues, people having to, you know, get caught up on bills. You will never know how that feels because you have not experienced fucking life. All you can do is sit and laugh. But bum, I like my life. I love my motherfucking life. I love the house that I fucking live in. I get to decorate it. All that shit. You sitting over there miserable in a dilapidated, cracked out community about to get your ass beat by a bunch of crackheads. And that, now that's gonna happen. That's definitely going to happen. Okay. All right, y'all. Bum. We know you're going to come back because you're just a liar. Liars have a tendency to do that. You'll just go on and on and on and on. I don't have to keep responding to you. You're pointless. You were on there showing pictures of a man's dick. Go get some fucking help. You look so stupid tonight that I didn't even have to do this live. But I did it anyway because people need to know the truth. Yes, Tiffany has been stalking me. In fact, I have over 50 police reports filed against Tiffany. What do you know? Want me to go pull that out? Want me to go over to DeKalb County Police Department and go ahead and pull all of those reports that I made? Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right, bum. Sit over there and accept what you got. You got a hole, which is what you wanted. I'm a little confused about why you're not happy with what you got. If you were truly happy with what you got and what you're doing in life, you wouldn't be stalking people. Because I'm going to tell you the truth. Your show sucks so much ass that you actually had to resort to start showing people's nude bodies. That's how bad your fucking show sucks ass at this point. Time to turn in your whistle, which really you never had a whistle. You just play back other people's shows and go, get. You've made a couple of dry parodies that nobody's going to fucking actually buy. And if you do, it's not going to pay a mortgage. It's not going to pay a car payment. Live your life and accept your life. Okay, and that's all I got to say. I got to go. That's real talk for the bum and Tiffany. Listen. I will be finally doing something about Tiffany and her stalking because Tiffany is genuinely stalking me. And that ain't no joke. And it's very creepy to have somebody that you used to know stalk you. Creepy. I am never in any chat rooms talking about Tiffany, ever. The only time I do talk about Tiffany is when I'm talking to people from a concept of don't judge me because of her. I don't want nothing to do with her. Yeah. And you'll find out the hard way, Tiffany, when I never call you, never contact you. And then also when I put you on ignore, because I'm ready to put you on ignore. That's both of you bums are on ignore as far as I'm concerned. I got way too much shit to do. Okay. All right, y'all.